So, what do you want to see in Bali, Georgia?
The beautiful island and the beach.
What?
The beaches.
Spell it. Charot. Hi guys, here we are in Bali already. Look at Georgia. Good morning.
Hello, welcome to Bali.
Hi Jerry. It's 7:30 in the morning here in Bali. So we will go to the hotel and change and freshen up, maybe having some breakfast, or maybe we can go out right away, depends, you know. I hope you guys will like this trip. We're here in Ibu Oki Nasi Ayam, very famous here in Nusa Dua for their chicken rice, the Balinese chicken rice. So we're gonna eat as breakfast or brunch, I don't know, while waiting for the rooms to be ready. So I'm still with the two Malditang Bakla. How are you?
I'm good.
So guys, we are here somewhere in Nusa Dua. So we found a place where we can have our dinner with them. Hi guys.
Hi.
I'm gonna show you some of the food we ordered. So basically, Georgia, have you picked up some Indonesian word?
No.
Okay. Let me teach you how to say thank you.
Salamat.
Terima
no.
kasih.
Terima kasih.
Terima kasih.
Yes. How are you?
I'm fine.
Apa kabar?
Apa kabar?
Apa kabar?
So for now, Georgia learned two phrases from Indonesian. So, how are you is?
Apa kabar?
And thank you is? Terima kasih.
Terima kasih.
So, we already have our food with us. So, first one is Ayam nyet-nyet. So this is a grilled chicken, Balinese style, with some chili and with rice, vegetable, corn fritters and cucumbers, and of course the sambal. And then next, nasi goreng kampung, meaning provincial nasi goreng or provincial fried rice with chicken satay on the side. And this is nasi campur, but vegetarian version. So we're all the, like this one, we have langka, and then we have long beans, tempeh, corn fritters, and eggplant, and sambal mata. Sambal mata is a traditional sambal from Bali. How do you like the food?
Super sarap, delicious. Taste from, para Filipino food din siya na may pagkaano.
You like it?
Yes, of course.
Sadap.
And this one sadap is bihun, fried bihun. So it's like the typical fried, stir-fried bihun. And of course, this is ketoprak. Ketoprak is like Indonesian salad. So it's like with all the shredded cabbage with some other vegetables and with peanut dressing. And then this is soto madura. It's a soup with noodle, glass noodle. So yeah, it's simple basic chicken soup. We are here in Bali, second day. So today we're checking out from Grand Wis Hotel in Nusa Dua and moving to Three Monkeys. So we're gonna meet the rest of the group there because tomorrow the wedding is somewhere there. So look who's with me today, who just arrived last night from the Philippines. Hi Tay. So kumusta? How's Bali?
I miss Bali. Hi guys.
So basically, if you are in Indonesia, Bali or Jakarta, if you want some spicy food, always go for Padang restaurant. Always look for Padang restaurant. Because everything in Padang restaurant very spicy, like this one, the beef rendang. You know, the beef rendang in the Philippines or other part of the world normally is brown. But in Indonesia, we always make it black because we want... it's a slow cook, so till the coconut milk cook really well and then becomes black. And then this is my favorite, sambal kentang, meaning potato sambal with some chicken gizzard and chicken liver. I love Padang food so much because kung baga sabi ng mga Filipino, sabi ni Georgia over there, because Padang food is tukoy sa may panlasa. Because I grew up and I was born in Padang, and then so the whole family, we are used with the Padang food. Kumbaga, it's like the king of cuisine in Indonesia, just like Bicolano food. So there, can you see the view? So nice, look at that. Morning! So it's our next morning here. Look at everyone hanging out here in the room.
Morning! I love you and I love you.
It's the wedding day, so we already prepare our outfit there. And sister of the groom. Yeah, and also the event organizer. Everything all in one.
Yes.
Here we are at the wedding venue. This is the makeup room with the bride. Beautiful bride and sister of the groom there, and the maid of honor, and the hairstylist,
and the homie.
The homies.
To achieve glowing skin for an outdoor wedding, it is important to have good skin. So brides really have to take care of their skin beforehand. For Elena's case today, she really has nice, beautiful skin. So I skipped foundation. I just used concealer on certain parts of her skin. I used less makeup on the skin and focus on the eyes, while still maintaining a toned-down approach on the eyes. I just played with texture like glitter on her eyes so that her eyes can come alive. Jerry did a simple classic updo to complement this fresh bronze bridal look. We're going out now for a late lunch because everyone was so drunk last night. We went to La Favela. Very nice place to hang out and chill. So many corners. Ateng, say hi.
Hi.
Bas, say hi.
Hi. Too.
Hi, Komang. We rent a car. So it's about 700,000 rupiah, more or less $50 per day. Like if you're in the group, so I think it's a little bit cheaper if you just rent. Say hi, Komang.
Hello, good afternoon.
Laban.
All good.
So Komang is always driving me around Bali every time I'm in Bali. Oh my god, guys, I have a question. Ara, What is your favorite restaurant here in Bali?
Watercress,
because all organic, healthy, brunch, you know, breakfast is nice also, no? Mario, what is your favorite hangout place in Bali?
La Favela.
Oh yeah, La Favela is very cool. Hi guys, here we are in Ubar. Hi guys.
Hi.
Hi guys. It's very nice here in Ubar. Very quiet and very relaxing.